My brothers and sisters, good afternoon, good afternoon, good afternoon, good afternoon. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us be joyous and be glad in it. It is a privilege every afternoon at this time, every day at this time, let's say it like that, that whenever we have the chance to come before you to bring the word of God. As I said, we are doing the wonderful, marvelous work of God. So I said, thank you for each and every one of you that already signed up or already joined my journey together. So because we, as we always say, every time we got a chance to sleep and wake up in the morning, breathe the air of the Lord, we have to say thank you. The reason why we have to say thank you, because there's so many people, especially in this pandemic that's going on, hundreds of thousands and thousands of people being killed by that virus. But God, by his wonderful and powerful mercy, he keeps us by keeping us safe. So we're still able to say hallelujah. We're still able to lift up our hands to say thank you to our Savior. So this is the day that the Lord has made. We are able to see another day, a day that so many people would love, would want, would pay money to see, they cannot see. So we thank God for you, and we thank God for your family. We thank God for each and every one of you. But all I'm asking you, as always, share the video. Share it with your friend and let your friend know that. Let your friend know. I'm by Bong Bong. How you doing, Bong Bong? Everybody's doing good. Everybody looking good. So every time you have a chance to listen to this, just share it with your other friends, because we need so many people to hear the truth of the Word of God. Because we're not here to make fans. We're not here to make popularity, but we are here just to bring the Word of God to you and give you some good music that will help you while we worship Him, while we give Him thanks, we praise Him. We need to do so, because if it wasn't for Him, we wouldn't be here tonight. We wouldn't be here to say the name of Jesus, because you know, in the name of Jesus, there's healing. In the name of Jesus, there's power. In the name of Jesus, there is deliverance, because He is our refuge, because He is our protector, because He is our Savior. He keeps us, even though men try to destroy humanity. But God says, that will do until I said so. But until I said so, my children will be protected. My children will be saved. My children will be covered under my wings. I will hide them. No pestilence, destroyer can come near their tent, because I am God all by myself. Thank you, Jesus, for allowing us to see another day. Thank you for letting us see a day that so many would like to see that didn't have the chance to see. We honor you. We praise you. We ask that in the name of Jesus, each and everyone that's going to be listening to this tonight or today broadcast, I ask that in Jesus' name for you to open doors for them. Bless them, heal their lands, heal their family, heal the sick, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray at this present moment for the people that live in New Jersey, those that are living in New York, Boston, in the red zone. And I pray for doctors and nurses and firefighters. I pray for those that are being work at the hospital. Every one of them, Father, I ask you that your mighty hands to be protect them. And I ask, as I come before you, Lord, if anything of me that's not of you, take it out. Take me out of your way. Use me so your people, your children, could hear the truth, and the truth will set them free. So make teaching easy for me, Lord. Make it easy. And as easy you make it, it's the better it would be for your children, because your children need to hear the truth, because the truth will set them free. So, Father, we thank you, we honor you, and we pray for those that are about to connect. We pray, Father God, for my sister Bruna Alcime. I pray that in your name, keep her family safe, keep Margaret safe, keep Febe safe, keep Wood safe, keep Jocelyn safe, Bidal safe, keep all the Alcime's family safe in Jesus' name. We pray for the Emilien family. We pray for Lucette Madi Vallon, Emilien. We pray for Mommy. We pray for Daddy in Canada. We pray, Father God, for Rose Fabienne in Canada. We pray for her mother that lives in New York. We pray for each and every one of us. We pray for Brother Alcy Paul. We pray for our Rose, sister Rose Caldeen, Suzette Michaud, Mary Yolene Samson. We pray for Ewald Emab. We pray for Pastor Omar, Pastor Wilfried Joseph. We pray for Diani Blank. We pray for Francois Victor. We pray for Adeline Blank. We pray for Dumessi Blank. We pray for Schneider Emilien. We pray for Elixir Jean Emilien. We pray, Father God, for each and every family in this planet. And I pray for Haiti. I will not forget Haiti. I will not leave Haiti behind, Father God, because you, while with your mighty hands, I pray that you offer protected Haiti, because you know, according to people, this is the country that have no medicine, no equipment to fight that invisible war. But I know in the name of Jesus Christ, we plead the Psalm 91. We plead the Psalm 91, and we plead the blood of Jesus over that country. We pray that you cover that country with your blood. It's not because that country is better than everywhere it was, but because of your kindness, because of the people, because of us that praying, we ask you, bless and protect in Jesus' name. Just like we pray for this country, we pray for this government, we ask you, Father God, to just, Father God, help this country, bless this country, and heal this country. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and amen and amen. So we pray as well for Silene Mathieu and Souvenir Mathieu. We pray for the mother. We pray for the brothers. We pray for Souvenir husband. And we pray that you keep him safe. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that you heal a mother, and I pray for Mommy Bo. I pray for each and everyone that's listening, in Jesus' name, amen, and amen, and amen, and amen. So my brothers and sisters, tonight we try to give you just come into the word. So my wife always says, you know, the people that love music, they love worshiping, why don't you worship more? But you know what, I am not concerning about how many people who want to dance, because we've been dancing all our lives. But what we miss is the word of God. We want you to listen to the word of God, because the word of God, that's the medicine. That's the medicine that will save you. That's the medicine that will heal you. So I understand the devil really don't want people to pay attention to the word of God. Like I've been saying, so what we are doing something that will bring people to heaven. But at the same time, the devil, once the devil's doing his stuff, more people spend time to watch the nastiest stuff, the immorality stuff, the immoral stuff. But not the moral, because now we are out of the morality. Even in church, we are out of morality. So we need to bring that back in church. We need to bring morality in church. We need to bring the purity in church. We need to bring holiness in church. We need to bring love in church. We need to bring Jesus inside the four walls, because of now everybody want to be a apostle, a bishop, a doctor, a prophet. But no one wants to take a little time to spend time and explain, even though they could do a better job, but they choose not to do it because they want to compromise. But as your servant, I don't want to compromise the word of God, because when I remember where God got me from, when I remember where God brought me out of, I cannot compromise the gospel. I cannot compromise the word of God. I have to be standing firm on my ground. Stand firm in the word of God. Remember last night or yesterday we talked about, we touches the, how did we get the Old Testament, and we find out how did we got it. We got it because God give the divine responsibility to the Jews. He gave them a divine responsibility to the Jews. So by to protect, to preserve. So because of that, God gives them the divine. God gives them the divine responsibility. They had to do it. And we find out how that was so divine, protected in 1947, they found the original copy of the Hebrews, the transcript, of the Bible, except the books of Esther. The book of Esther wasn't included in it in 1947. They found it, and then you know what? Everything that the Jews wrote thousands of 1947 years after the manuscript that was wrote 200 years before Jesus Christ. He wrote 200 years before Jesus Christ, and then they found the original 1947 after Jesus Christ. Everything that was in the Old Testament except Esther was exactly the same. That's how divine and how protected God is to his word, because his word is his everlasting word, is unbreakable, it's unperishable, it's infallible. So that's why whatever he says 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 years ago, still good for today's, the day that we're living in. Therefore, so now today we're going to see, and then after that, we saw nine characteristics or nine qualification for those, for the people that that were in charge to make the copy of the original transcript that God gave to the Jews responsibility. So we found nine of them. First of all, they have to know, they have to be clean, they have to went to training for so many years, and then not only they have to be going to training for so many years, they have to memorize, to be able to memorize 4,000 words, 4,000 Judaic laws. They have to memorize 4,000, at least 4,000 of the Judaic laws. They have to memorize that 4,000 of the laws of the Judaic. So, and then not only they have to do that, they have to and the copying of the Holy Spirit, they have to make numerous count. They have to count. They have to count, they have to check, they have to balance. That's what we spoke yesterday. That's why we see. I'm trying to make a recap for those that didn't have a chance to listen to it. And then not only they have to do that, and they have to make it sure, ensure the occurrence of the scripture. They'll be the keepers. They have to be a custodian to it. They were called the custodian keepers of the scriptures. And then first, they have to be able to memorize, to not to write by memory. They have to be not writing by memory. They have to be able to write word by word, pronounce every one of them, every letters before they even put it down in the papers. Secondly, they had to always be exactly 42 sentences or 42 lines on each page. They have to be exactly 42 lines and on each page. Thirdly, they have to count the numbers of the words in each book. They have to count the numbers of the of each the numbers of the letters of each book. And fourthly, they have to be able to count the numbers and the letters in each book, like 3,804,805, like a Hebrew letters and the Torah. The Torah count, let me spell it for 3,400, 3,000, 3,004,805 Hebrew letters was in the Torah. Let me say it again. 3,004,805 Hebrew letters in the Torah. Number five, they had to point out the middle letters in the entire Torah. They have to point out the middle letter in the entire Torah. And six, they have to point out the middle letter in the entire Bible. They have to be able to point out the middle letter in the entire Bible. Seven, before they even write the name of God, they have to wipe down the pen. They've been raining off. They wipe it down, and then they go take a shower. They clean themselves. And then before they can even put the pen down to write the name of God. Eight, if they made a mistake on one sentence, they have to invalidate everything. Everything have to be invalidated. They could not make any mistakes. And nine, it took them about a year to write the five books of the Torah, the five books in the Bible. It took them about one year to write the five books. Now today we just gonna see that's what we touched yesterday. Today we're gonna see how we got to the New Testament. So how we got the New Testament? If for the first 25 to 30 years of church history there were no New Testament. Watch this. For the first 25 to 30 years after Christ, there wasn't any New Testament. Scriptures, the gospel was passed on by word of mouth by the apostle, like we can see at Hebrew chapter 2, verse 1 to through 4. Let's look. Hebrew, so you know I like to read the scripture, because I tell you, we're not doing religions, the religion and the other one. We're not teaching you doctrine, so we're just doing the Bible. We follow what the Bible says. So we're just giving you the insight, so you know for yourself what you have in your hand, the power, the weapon you have in your hand, that you've been playing with it. That's why the devil got you the way he gets you, where he got you, because you've been playing with the Bible. You don't take time to read your Bible. And I can tell you, even in this difficult time, I can tell you how many times that we, as the body of Christ, we sit down with our family and read the Bible. How many times we've been doing it? Maybe zero. But we have time to do everything else. We have time to talk to friends, family, your chat on Facebook, chat on WhatsApp, chat on you name it. But how many times you chat in the Bible? Well, you know why? Because this weapon, it's a weapon that every time you open it, war start in devil camp. So the devil understand that he does not want fight. So that's why he keeps you away from the Bible. So me, I like to read my Bible and I like to share it with you. So we said from the first 25 to 30 years, we did not have any Bible, but the word of God went mouth to mouth of the apostle. We can see that in Hebrew chapter 2 verse 1 to 4. So there we go. You must teach what is in accord with sound doctrine. Teach the older men to be tempered or temperate, worthy of respect, self-control, and sounds and faith, and love and endurance. Likewise, teach the older woman to be reverent in the way they live, not to be slanderers or addicted to much wine, but to teach what is good. Then they can train the younger woman to love their husband and children. You get that? So that's how the word of God been doing. So it goes that we have to teach the old man. We have to teach with sound doctrine, which is Pastor Mark, your servant, is not doing doctrine with you, but that's how the New Testament came out. So we had to teach the sound doctrine, good stuff from the Lord Jesus. So we don't want to hear like people today. Let me just pause a little bit. So today I said that a lot of time. I say today everybody can call themselves pastor. Everybody can call themselves apostle. Everybody can call themselves bishops. Everybody can call themselves archbishop. You just name it, because it's a title. People like title. So that's why people promote themselves to which office they like to. Like I was saying to some people yesterday, to my wife yesterday, I probably did say that to Souvenir as well. So if I wanted to become an archbishop today, all I have to do tomorrow when I come back here, I said, this is Archbishop Mark Emilian. And people will start calling me archbishop. But I don't have no training for that office. I cannot teach the right words of God to the people of God. But I'm apostle. I'm archbishop. I'm bishop. I'm a pastor. But as I can see in the Bible, every office, God himself sends, in the Old Testament, God himself sent a prophet to ordain whoever that he wants to elevate it to a higher office. In the New Testament, we see after the death of Judas, the apostles left 11, so they needed to replace another one at his position. But they went in prayer, they prayed God to open up their spirit, their mind, their understanding to make the right choice to ordain somebody to replace Judah. So they didn't just pick it up and say, you apostle. No. There were a ceremonial, apostolic ceremonial that, or we can call it ordination, that took place to replace Judas. In every segment in life, there should be a recognition of who elevates you to the higher office. But today, that's why there are so many divisions in church, because just because I don't like to hear this preacher preach, I think I can do better than that preacher, and I just divide the church and call myself a pastor. What kind of pastor are you, my brother? Because the Bible says in every kingdom, if there is any division, the kingdom will fall apart. Because, why is that? Because God understands the importance of unity. God understands the importance of unity. So unity is something that God endorses. That's why he asks us to love one another. He asked us to follow him. He asked us to imitate him. So therefore, when I see people calling themselves names, I'm wondering. That's why we so church full of pride people. Church don't have the same power they should have because of pride. Because I am a bishop, I am an archbishop, pride. But God wants you to be humble. God wants you to love one another. And that's why Apostle Paul, before for the first 25 to 30 years ago, there were only go word of mouth of the apostle. But at the same time, he says it was sound doctrine. Teach the old man to be temperated. We have to be tempered. We have to be kind. We have to be nice. Teach the old man to understand how to be nice to one another. Teach them to be worthy, worthy of respect. They have to have respect for themselves and respect for others. Teach the old men. Teach the old men to have respect and to have respect. Not only have respect, but teach the older woman to be the good woman and to be teach the older woman so there could be wise respect to their husband, love their husband, and again, not only Lupe, my sister, thank you, not only to respect the husband, so they can be able to teach their children, the younger woman. So that's why today I want to pause today, because today I cannot see any older woman that take the responsibility to teach the younger woman to respect and love their husband. Because today, the older woman, they act like they're young. So when I was growing up, the older woman, they were so respected, you know. If the woman was about 30 years old, then the woman, no younger man than like 18, 19, 20 can come in and talk to them. They will not dress any kind of ways. You call them auntie. You know, even though they're 30 years old, you probably 19, you still call them auntie because the way they dress. But today, you see, people 70 or 60 something and 70, 75 dressed just like the 18 years old girl. And they're on Facebook and chatting with younger kids, like the 19 or 18 years old kids and 70 years old women. You know, how you gonna teach the young girl to respect themselves while you doing Jezebel? So that's the problem. So the older woman cannot teach the younger woman anymore because the older think that he's still young. And they do not act as a woman of respect, of virtue. They just act just like the 17 years old girl. You can see the older woman tattoo all over the body, all over the, and they walk up around the street, the belly button outside. They put some tight clothes, tear up clothes, and earrings all over their nose, their eyebrows, and the ears, and the mouth, their tongue. They put all of these things. So how are you gonna train a 16 years old girl to be pure and to be holy in the presence of God? How are you gonna do that? And you act that way. So that's why Apostle Paul wanted them to teach the older woman to respect themselves. But today, no respect. No respect. People have no morality. I remember when I was growing up, I would doom if I could come in front of a 40 years old girl or 40 years old woman and come and stand in front of her, look at her in her eyes. She smacked me, and then I couldn't go home to say what was going on because of what happened. I would get another whooping outside. But today you can do that. can do that. So there's no respect. So that's why the Bible was talking like that. But we must pray. We must pray. We must pay more careful attention, therefore. So we're still going on. And we must pay careful attention. Careful attention to what we have heard so that we do not drift away. So that's what Apostle was saying. God bless you too, Sister Lupe. So that's why the Apostle was pay attention more careful. So you don't just listen to every text. That's why I'm telling my kids, don't listen to any kind of music, because what you allowed your mind to listen, and that's gonna filter inside of your soul, and that's gonna determine who you are. So who you listen to make who you are. So that's why myself, I only listen to God music and God words. I do not listen to any kind of stuff. Why? Because I do not want them to mess up my well-being in the Lord. He said, so that we do not drift away. For if the message spoken by angel was biding in every violation and disobedience, we receive its just punishment. How shall we escape if we ignore such a great salvation? This salvation, which was first announced by the Lord, was confirmed to us by those who heard him. God also testified to it by signs, wonders, and various miracles and gifts of the Holy Spirit distributed according to his will. Jesus made like his brother. So, that's what the apostle was trying to explain to the people. He says, we have to very carefully pay attention, carefully of what we listen. Because what we listen, it could make a big difference, a big change in our lives. Therefore, we are to understand and how to make things happen in the Lord. So my brothers and sisters, we want you to understand how did we get the New Testament, because we show you how we get the Old Testament. So they were using the Old Testament scriptures, which was already in existence for centuries and had been used by Jesus and his teaching as the basic of the gospel and teaching. They have been listening and using the Old Testament because that was already in place, and Jesus himself was using him as well for the gospel and the teaching. But the church began to grow so fast and large that the true and continuity of the gospel's message was becoming distorted and perverted, making it necessary to produce writing documentation of the life and teaching of Jesus Christ. So after Jesus, so the church began to grow so fast that the truth and continuity of the gospel message was becoming distorted and perverted. So that make it necessary to produce the writing documentation of life and teaching of Jesus Christ. The four Gospels become some of the earliest written of the New Testament. They were written by to clarify the teaching of Jesus Christ and to ensure the believers that what they had been taught by the apostle about Jesus Christ was in fact the truth. That's why they said, you know what? Because we see the church grow so fast and large, we need to bring the gospel of Jesus Christ written. Because the continuity of the gospel message was become distorted. You know, everybody take it in their sense, the way to make that can make them feel good. Everybody, that's why everybody come on Facebook with a different Jesus, which we all are speaking about only one Jesus. But each of us take the Jesus at a different level. But all I'm trying to tell everybody, we are a lot of members in one body. So do not fight one another. Let's help one another to bring the gospel where it needed to go. So if you say amen, that would not hurt that much. So he says we have to bring the gospel. So that's why they bring the four apostles first. The epistles were written to correct the false teaching that had crept into the church and to clarify the true doctrine and teachings of the kingdom of God. So that's why the epistle of Mark, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. So these four epistles or chapter or the early beginning. So this guy says, you know, we have to write something so we can correct. We can clarify the true doctrine and teaching of the kingdom of God. So there were only 8 New Testament writers. All of them were apostles who had actually seen and heard Jesus' teaching, and or men who had been their companion. So these apostles, they were there. They heard it, they seen it, they heard it, they seen the teaching, and they heard it. So there were 8 of them, and some of the other men that was Jesus' companion. Matthew, John, Peter, and Paul were apostles. Mark and Luke were companions of the apostle. James and Jude were the brothers of Jesus. Luke was the only non-Jewish writer of scripture. Luke was the only non-Jewish writer of scripture. So God himself, he says, let's do that. He showed them, do you know what? This is what we're going to do. We're going to write some stuff so people could understand, because there's so much false teaching. And even today, we are false teachers. We are false doctors, which I have a brother that called some teaching that I was doing. He says, that's a false doctrine. You know, something that I did, which I'm not doing any doctrinal things of what we do in Jesus Christ. So I just want to mention that. So there's so many false teachers out there. And that's why the Bible says to us to be vigilant and listen more carefully of whom you spend your time to listen to. Because today we make, because I see all over the world, people so sensitive, so emotional. And people all about miracles, you know, more about prosperity. So things like that get people so excited and they want to give. But people take a lot of advantage of you because of your lack of knowledge. But my duty to you is to teach you the principle and how that we can live good with one another. All I ask, just that. So I just want you to understand God's prophetic calendar for the world. Whoa. God's prophetic calendar for the world. God does something arbitrarily. According to the scripture, everything that God is doing on earth, under heaven, is based on time and season. Everything God does in time under heaven, Miss Suzette, He does it under, based on time and season. If we look at Ephesians 1:11. So I'm not going to take time because I'm going to shut it down a little bit. Ephesians, I'm going to just read for you Ephesians, and tomorrow we will continue with this chapter. I'm just going to read Ephesians 1:11. So, just be patient with me. We're right there. Okay, verse 11. It says like this. And him we were also choosing, having been predestined according to the plan of him who works out everything in conformity with the purpose of his will. So we've been choosing to live. We were predestined. It wasn't something that we do just because we were predestined. God was already choosing time and season. So I will continue with the chapter tomorrow. So God has chosen to walk through multiple of seven and is dealing with men and the world, beginning with the number seven in creation. Through the seven annual feasts of the Jewish nation, and through the multiple of seven in the books of Daniel, God has given us a prophetic outline of time for the history and of the world. According to the scripture, the history of the entire world is interwoven in the history of the Jewish people. So my sister and brother, God does the creation. Everything God does it with time and season. And God choosing to walk through a multiple of seven. Seven. And it start with men. Seven. And it comes in Daniel book, seven, multiple seven stuff happening. Seven feasts. We will look into that tomorrow. Seven feasts. But all I'm telling you today, my brother, like this morning I was talking with the Haitian community. I was talking about, I always like to take a little zip in it to you. I was talking about the danger that is of the lovers of money, people who love money so much. And God tells us in Matthew 6, verse 19 through 33 or 34. What we should not do and what we should do. So I want you to read Matthew 6, 19 and through 33. So to my family and my friend in Nassau, Bahamas, so I pray God for you. Pastor Jason Blanc, I pray God for you. Suzette, I pray God for you. And I pray God for each and every one of you. And I thank you for being with us tonight. So I will see you again tomorrow. Just before I leave, let me let you listen to this beautiful song, and then I will pray for you. Oh, instead of putting up the volume, I bring it down. There we go. Time like this, we need time like this. We need a little time that we can relax with the Lord. Relax with the Lord. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Uh-huh. Yes. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, we honor you, we bless your name. Thank you for allowing us to be here tonight. And we hope to see my people, my friends, my brothers, my sisters again the next time. I pray that you cover them under your shadow. I pray, Father God, you keep them. Protect their family. Protect their family. Protect that everything they do. Keep them safe. Until we return again. We love you. We honor you. We give you praise. We give you honor. We worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Jesus, there's none like you. There's none like you. So we pray blessing over Suzette Michaud and her family, her children. I pray blessing upon Justin Blanc and Nassau Bahamas and all the friends, family in Nassau Bahamas, Islan, Simon. I pray for them, Lord. I pray for you to keep them safe, protect them, cover the children, protect their family. I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus for my family, the children you have me watch over. I pray for this well-being. Keep them safe, Lord. Protect them. Protect my family. Protect this country. Protect those that are working in the hospital. Jocelyn, protect her, Father God. Keep her safe. My friends, my brothers and sisters on Facebook, those that always watch every day, morning and night, they're there to watch, to be, listen to you. So I ask that you bless them. I ask that you keep them safe. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We love you. We honor you. And we bless your name. Hallelujah. Let the music play a little bit for me, please. And I'm done. I'm done. She wants to go. Let my people listen to me. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Father God. Gloire à Dieu. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I believe. I believe. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Mm. Gloire à Dieu. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to you, God. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. God bless you to my son. God bless you to my son. Yes, bon Dieu béni. Yes. 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 Oh Lord, I am yours. I believe. Amen. I believe. I believe. God bless you. Have a blessing night, a blessing day. Shalom. Shalom. Shalom.